Good morning, my dear students. Hope all are fit and fine at home. So in the previous session, we have started the new chapter. And what is the name of the chapter? Yes, you are right. The name of the chapter is Evolution of Communication. In that, we have covered some points. Which are the points? Remembered or forgot? I think you people have remembered the point, na? Which are the points? First, we have studied that what is communication, na? Sending or receiving messages are called communication. And after that, which point is that? That is the need for writing. Why? The people, they started writing, na? And for that, I have given you some example also. Need for writing. Why the people need the writing? Like example I have given, I have given some question answer to you. And 3-4 question answers, you have to learn it. Okay? Now, no written question answer I have given. Only learn, you have to learn orally. What happened after 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks? You started forgetting the answer. Na? And after that, if I ask you to, okay, now give me the answer of what is communication? You started thinking and some words you missed. Na? So that is why the writing is needed. Okay. As example, one more example I gave you. In class 1, you have, sorry, class 3, you have studied about the solar system. Now, if I ask you now that, okay, name the hottest planet. Okay. You started thinking, which is the hottest planet? Which is the hottest planet? After that, you recall and you can say that, okay, Venus is the hottest planet. After that, if I ask, okay, which planet is called the blue planet? No? Then you started thinking, and if you don't remember, then what happened? You forgot the answer. But if you have written the answer, then you can open your class 3 copy. If you are having the copy or if you are having the book, you can open the book or you can open the copy. You can see the answer and you can give the answer. So, because of that all things, writing is very important. So, in the past time also, the people, they need the writing. Why? Because they want to keep the records, how much business they have done, what they have sell out, or what they have imported or what they have exported. For all that things, they need the record and they need the written record. So that is why they need the writing. After that, that next topic is the pigeon post. Na? That postal system is not available. Then mail is not there. Then phone calls were not there. No text messages were there. So how the people they were writing? They were sending through the send their letters through the pigeons. Na? Okay. After that, next point is the postal services. Na? In that postal services, the people they started sending the letters through the post office. All these topics we have covered in the last session. Now, this session, we will start some new topic, okay? Now, what is the topic? The topic is invention in communication, okay? Now, in that, we have to cover these points. Printing press, the telegraph, the telephone, the television, computer and the internet and satellites, okay? Now, before that, I will read the chapter. Just look in your book, okay? Inventions in communication. Many inventions help to ease communication. Let us read about them. Printing press. In the beginning, books were written and copied by hand. It was very slow process. This handwritten books were very expensive. Very few people could buy and read such books. The Chinese were the first to develop the art of printing. But the method was difficult and thus not popular. In the 15th century, Johannes Gutenberg invented the printing press. He used metal blocks that had individual letters of the alphabet carved on them. Each metal block could be moved around to print words. sentences. This made the process of printing much easier. Gutenberg printing press made it possible to make more copies in the lesser time and at much lower cost. As a result, books became cheaper. They also became easily available to common people. Next, telegraph. Between 1830s and 1840s, Samuel Morse invented an instrument that could send messages to any part of the world through wires by using electrical signals. This instrument was called the telegraph. Messages could be sent in a coded language of dots and dashes. This code language was called the Morse code. In a time when there was no telephone or internet, a telegraphic message that could be sent and received within not more than 5 minutes was a revolution. However, with the coming of new and better technologies in the 21st century, the telegraph was replaced and no longer used. Next, the telephone. In 1876, Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone. It became the fastest means of communication of time. People use the telephone to speak anyone in the world. In recent time, mobile phones have become more popular device of communication. The radio. The radio was invented by Galileo Marconi in the late 19th century. Before the advent of the television, the radio was a popular source of entertainment and news. Next, the television. The television was invented in the beginning of the 20th century. John Lloyd was used everyday objects such as biscuit tins and bicycle lamp to put together the first ever television. The television quickly became one of the most powerful tools of communication in the world. People could now watch both live and recorded programs. It is also a source of education as well as entertainment. Computer and the internet. I hope you people are very familiar with the computer and internet. Now we are through the internet only. The teachers are teaching you online through the help of the computer or through the help of the laptop and internet. Okay. So the computer and the internet transform the way we communicate. In the beginning, computers were huge machines that were as big as a large room. However, computers as you know them today are sleek devices that easily fit into a wrist watch. Smart watches are coming. Many of you are having also that smart watches, like that type of watches, okay? Wrist watch. The internet came into being in the 20th century. It created a global system of interconnected computer. Through email, blogs, videos and social networking sites, the internet made it possible for people to communicate with each other almost instantly. Apart from communication, the internet today is used for a variety of purposes such as for accessing information on any topic, booking tickets, making bill payments, shopping, ordering foods, and so on. The internet has thus made communication faster and cheaper. Next, satellites. More than 2,000 human-made satellites have been sent into space and are currently orbiting our planet. Satellites receive signal from the Earth and transmit them back. As satellites are placed above the Earth's surface, the signal can reach anywhere on Earth. Before satellites came to be used, mountains or tall buildings were blocked Television signals and phone calls could not be placed to far off places. Satellites have made it possible for us to watch live coverage of musical performances and cricket matches from anywhere in the world. Phone calls too can be placed anywhere in the world. Apart from enabling communication, satellites also capture images of the earth which can be used for research. They help in forecasting the weather as well. So this is about the reading part. Now I will explain the chapter. So let's see the chapter. Here it is written, inventions in communication. Many inventions help on ease communication. Let us read about them. So in that, first one is the printing press. In the 15th century, John and Gutenberg invented the printing press. So here you can see, this is first the printing press is like this. After that, they made the printing press like this. It's the printing press here. The newspaper, books, magazine, all were printed. Okay. This is the first previous one. Present one time. Printing press. Okay. So in the 15th century, John and Gutenberg invented the printing press. But before that, the Chinese, they were first developed the art of printing. But the method was very difficult to understand. Okay. So the people, they did not understand how to print the books or newspaper or other things. So it is not. So that is why this Chinese printing press were not popular. Later on in the 15th century, the John and Gutenberg invented the printing press. And what he used the metal blocks, individual letters, na? Alphabets were there, na? So these alphabets individually, it is fixed, okay? And each metal box could be moved around to print words and sentences. Like in your laptop or in your computer, the alphabets, individual alphabets were there. Same like that in the printing press, John Gutenberg printing press, the individual metal blocks were there. That time this plastic or this rubber is not available. So he made the metal blocks, okay? Each alphabets individual. And with the help of that, they print the words and sentences, and this made the process of printing much easier, and it is very successful also. After that, it make it possible for the people to make the copies in the lesser time and much lower cost, in a less cost. Okay. Now the Bible was the first book printed on Gutenberg printing press. Okay. Now coming to the next topic, that is the telegraph. Here, between 1830s and 1840s, Samuel Morse invented an instrument that could send messages. Now we can send the messages through the WhatsApp or Messenger on our phone. That normal texts were also available, so we can send the messages through that. But in the past time, it is, these things were not available. These mobiles and laptops and computer was not invented that time. How we will send the messages? Through the telegraph. In the very previous time, the people used the postal system. Later on, they invented the telegraph. Who invented the telegraph? Samuel Morse invented the telegraph. And when he invented the telegraph? Between 1830s and 1840s. Okay. Now, these telegraphs were the, the people send the messages using the wires. Electrical signals were there. Okay. And messages could be sent in a coded, normal languages, normal alphabets were not there in that. They use the coded language. And what are the codes and language? The coded language are of dots and dashes were there. So these dots and dashes, there is some meaning of that. There is some language of that. Okay. And this coded language was called the Morse code.
Now, in a time when there was no telephone or internet or telegraph, messages that could be sent and received within not more than 5 minutes. Okay? So, when the telephone, internet, all these facilities were not there, so the people, they used the telegraphic message, and these telegraphic message could be sent within a 5 minutes. Okay, now you are using the WhatsApp and Messenger, or you can send your message through your friends, through your relatives, and within a second it reached the, when you press the send button, instantly it reached to the other person, na? But it take the telegraphic messages, it take at least 5 minutes to reach that person. Okay, so the coming of new better technologies in the 21st century, the telegraph was replaced and no longer used. Now the people, they are not using this telegraph method. Why? Because when these mobile phones, telephones, computer, internet, these all were invented, then the people, they found difficult to send the messages through the telegraph. Now, they need some relax. They got some relaxation. Now, it is very easy for them to send the messages or to send the letters or to send the messages through the computer, through the mobile phone, through the WhatsApp, Messenger, using all these things. It is easy language also. In the telegraphic, it is very difficult. That code, first they have to learn the code. Through that code, they have to type, and other person also should also learn the code. Otherwise, that code is useless, waste. Okay? So, it is little bit difficult. So, when internet or this telephone, mobile phone invented, after that, the use of telegraph was no longer, they were using it. Okay, now coming to the telephone. Now, our topic next is the telephone. And who invented the telephone? Telephone was invented by Alexander Graham Bell in 1876. And it became the fastest means of communication. Okay, now people use the telephone to speak anyone in the world. Okay, anywhere they connect, they dial the number and they can talk to their relatives, friends, or whatever information they have to give, they can send it through the telephone. Okay, now coming to the next point here, you can see how the telephone has developed. Here, the first one you have seen here, this one. Now, these phones were used during your great grandparents' time. Second number, this one. This phone was used during your grandparents' time. Here, this one, this phone you have seen. These two phones were popularly used by your parents when they were young. Okay? And here you can see smartphones. Okay? In recent time, the smartphone is the most commonly used device. Your parents, your brother, sister, they are using these phones. So here you can see that developed. Okay, how the telephone has developed. These were used by the great parents. These were used by your grandparents, great grandparents, grandparents. Then these were used by your parents. And these, the present time, the people, they are using it. Okay. Okay, now coming to the next point, that is the radio. Okay. Here, nowadays you people have seen that radio, new type of radio, okay? But it was invented by the Guglielmo Marconi, okay? And when it was invented in the late 19th century. Now, before the television invented, the people, the entertainment, or they get the news from the radio before the television invented. Okay, so the radio was a popular source of entertainment and news in the past time. Before the television invented, before that, the people, they use this device to get the information, that entertainment, the dramas or the news, they get from the radio. Coming to the next, that is the television. The television was invented in the beginning of the 20th century. John Louis Bade. And who invented the television? The television invented by the John Louis Bade. And when it was invented? It was invented in the 20th century. Okay. Now this John Louis Bade used every day the objects such as biscuit tins, bicycle lamps, all that, and he put together all these things to make the television. Okay. Now the television quickly became one of the most powerful tools of communication in the world, because through the television we get all the news. Now whole world news we can see on the television. Everywhere, that whatever the latest news we can see, the latest movie we can see, the drama we can see, the cartoons we can see. So it became more powerful tools of communication. People, they can now watch both live and recorded program, live cricket match, live any award events, and live any show is going on anywhere in the world, we can watch on the television. Okay. It is also a source of education. By seeing the Discovery Channel and other channel, History Channel, we get some information also. So it is also a source of education and as well as the entertainment. Some serials we can watch on the television, some dramas we can see, that Ramayana, Mahabharata, all these serials we can watch on the television, and by reading it or by going through that reading it, it's make very difficult, but by watching it, it makes very easily, clearly understood. So by that, we came to know all the story of that Lord Rama and other things. Okay. Coming to the next, computer and internet. I think computer and internet, no need to tell you about more about all these things, because already you are learning a computer subject and you very well know about what are the uses of internet. Na? So computer and internet transformed the way we communicate. Okay. In the beginning, computer were huge machines, big machines. Okay. Computer were big machines. Okay. And it occupy a big room also. Computer, as you know them today, are sleek device, very thin, na? That device, that the screen is there, then CPU, monitor, small parts were there. So it is a sleek device, but in the beginning it was very big device. Okay. Now the computer, you can wear it on your hands also as a smartwatch. Na? Using a smartwatch, many of you are having a smartwatch at home, so you can use it. Okay. So that is smartwatch also. Next is the internet. Came into being in the 20th century and it created a global system of interconnecting computer. Through one internet, many of the computers were connected. Through mails, blogs, video and social networking sites, the internet made it possible for people to communicate with each other almost instantly. Through the Google, you can search anything, whatever topic, you just type the topic and you will get the information instantly. Okay. So apart from communication, the internet today is used for a variety purposes, such as for accessing information on any topic. Teacher gave you a homework to write an essay. Now it is easy for you. You went home, after that you asked the phone, mobile phone from your parents, from mommy, papa, and you started typing on the Google, okay, the journey by a train, or that essay on Mahatma Gandhi, and easily you get all the details, and that you just copy it and bring it to next day to your teacher, and you show that to your teacher. So it is very easy. It made the life very easy. You can book the ticket also, movie ticket, train ticket, aeroplane ticket, any type of ticket you can make it. Bill payments also, your parents, they are paying the bill, electricity bill, then water tax, or many other taxes, many bills, okay. You can shopping also, no, through many the sites were available. You can go through the sites and you can shop anything, whatever you want. And now the Swiggy and the Zomato and all these things were available. So you can ordering the food also. Na? So all these things, how it is possible? Because of the internet. And if internet is not there, then what happened? Tell me what happened. No, the mobile phone, nothing you can do. No shopping, no ordering food, nothing you can do. So internet is very important part, na? Okay. And it is also faster and the cheaper. Okay. Now, next is the satellites. More than 2,000 human-made satellites have been sent into space are currently orbiting our planet. How many satellites? 2,000 human-made satellites. Okay. And what is satellite? Satellites receive signal from the Earth and then transmit them back. Like if we are watching the live cricket, how it is possible? It is possible because of only the satellites. Because the satellites, it revolve around the Earth and it catch the program and send it through our television, transmit them back in our television. Okay, as the satellites are placed above the Earth's surface, the signal can be reached anywhere on the Earth. No one that anywhere, wherever you live, here in India, in America, in Japan, and anywhere, London, anywhere you live, it gave you the signal. Now, before when the satellites were not there, the mountains or tall buildings would block the television or the phone signals. The people, they could not play calls or they could not see the television far off places. And because of the satellites, it made it possible for us to watch live coverage of any cricket, musical show, or the movie, or any event we can see live. Okay? Phone calls too can be placed anywhere in the world. As example I gave you, you have dialed the number in your mobile phone. First, it was connected through the satellites and then it goes to the another person phone. That is why it takes some seconds that when the bell goes there to the other person, it takes some seconds. Okay, like you have dialed your friend's number, whatever number you have dialed, after few seconds only the ring started going. How? Why? Because it is connected through the satellites. So through the satellites we can do a phone call anywhere in the world. So this is about the invention in communication. Okay. Now I hope that the chapter is clear to you all. No? And if it is not clear, please in the previous sessions also I told you, in the previous videos I told you, please note down the points which topic is not clear to you. And when the school reopen, you can ask me that, miss, this topic is not clear to me. Please explain once again and I will explain the topic. Okay? Okay, now we will do the book exercise and rest of the question answer I will show you. So let's do the book exercise.
Okay, so page number 42. A, match the columns. Okay, in that first word, radio. Okay, and the answer is, first answer is the D. What is the answer? D, that came before the television. Okay. Came. Radio. Came. Before. The. Television. Okay. Second. Telegraph. Answer. A. Used electrical signal to send messages. A. Use electrical signals from the Earth. Okay, then third,
signals to the send messages. Okay, third one, telephone became the fastest means of communication. Third one is the B one. Okay, became the fastest means of communication. Okay, now fourth one, printing press. E. Okay, what is the answer? Made it possible to make more copies of book. Made it possible to make more copies of book. Okay, fifth one is the human-made satellites. Answer D. Came before the television. Answer D. Came before the television. Sorry. Answer is receive signal from the earth. Okay. Receive signal from the earth. It's not D. It's C. Receive signals from the earth. Okay, so here is the answer. First D, second A, okay, then third B, fourth E, and fifth C. Next, fill in the blanks. B, fill in the blanks. In that first one, early humans used dash for words and sounds. What? Symbols. Symbols. Okay? Second, dash were used before the use of postal services. Homemade pigeon. Homing pigeons. Third, Samuel Morse invented the dash telegraph. Fourth, dash became one of the most powerful tools of communication in the world. Television. Fifth, dash have made it possible for us to watch live coverage of cricket match. Answer, satellite. So here is the answer. First, symbol. Second, homing pigeons. Third, telegraph. Fourth, television. And fifth, satellites. Now, if it is not clear to you all, answers are available on a school website. Please log in the website, download the answers, and write down in your book and your copy. Now, I will show you the answer of rest of the rest of the answers I will show you through the slides. Okay, now answer number, question number 3. Write a short note on printing press. Answer 3. In the 15th century, Johannes Gutenberg invented the printing press. He used metal blocks that had individual letters of the alphabet carved on them. Each metal block could be moved around to print words and sentences. This made the process of printing much easier. Moving to the next question. Who invented the telephone? How did it help in communication? Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone. It became the fastest means of communication of the time. People used the telephone to speak anyone in the world. Moving to the next question. What changes did the internet bring about? Answer 5. The internet made it possible for people to communicate with each other almost instantly. It has changed businesses, education, government, healthcare, and even the way in which we interact with our loved ones. Now, these answers are also available on our school website. Please log in our school website and download the answers. Okay, and write down the answers in your copy. That's all for today's session. Thank you.